And you know I don't need no favors. You know I don't need no favors. I'm the bitch on and off for the cameras. Type of bitch few people can handle. And I walk like I know my pussy dangerous. African bad girl giving them sugar. Tiny waist wild like Google. Get the money, that's my slogan.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to another video. In today's video, we're gonna do a little bit of a glam since I got this blonde hair and it's giving very much Elle Woods, like it's making me feel like such a Barbie. Of course, I have the video of me installing the hair because this video is sponsored by Unice Hair. This is their 613 body wave hair in 24 inches, I believe. This is the box it came in. They also sent me a bunch of goodies in the box. Came with a little scarf, it has their logo on it, some purple clips, a wig cap, another scarf, this one is orange, Unice hair lashes, of course.
Fuck me, baby. Leather seat, so she wet it in the room now. When the thing go up, then she go down. Yes, I'm the Baba. Don't rock Prada. What's a stylist? I'd rather make my clothes merch by the boat though. Banana club popping up, I'm super biased. Tint so black, look like my complexion. Leo, I'm the one, like I had direction. Rims look like they was shipped from heaven. Trunk so big, he could fit my reverend. Yeah, and that nigga's pretty big. Engine so fast, every block is a trip. Baby girl, wish that I copped the two-seater, but I had to get five, cause my niggas wanna ride.
Fuck you, pay me. Rolling deeper than a dare when we go out. If the ladies show up, then we show out. With my girl in my red Mercedes. Attitude like fuck me, baby. Leather seat, so she wetter than a room now. When the thing go up, then she go down.
This is just a preview, I use my gas for later. Black ice, black seats, yup, I'm bumping black star. Rednecks tell me that I got a nice car. Gotta make sure that I keep my baby thin. Scamming keep me hungry like I'm Katniss Everdeen. Just got a lip gloss, shining like it's pitch posh. It just sound like it need an ad-lib from Rick Ross. Y-A-M-M-G, but my next purchase might be an M3. Sick of the most, look at the folk, tripping for dollars, so hard to forgo. Picking apart my bottoms like when Peter Piper flick his nose. Lip, look like it got dipped in a cherry coke.
We're gonna do my makeup, and of course, I'm gonna be starting off with my brows like I always do, y'all. My brows are on, but I think I should make a TikTok, so I'm gonna look for a sound. I'm gonna put this on, get the baby hairs out of the way. Okay. Much better. How have you guys been? I feel like I've been very MIA. Well, maybe because I haven't done a sit-down video in a while, that's why I feel like that. I don't know. very interested to answer y'all's questions. I already did my brows, which are the part that I just wanted to like get out of the way so that they would look good and stuff. I have a freaking sty. It's so disgusting. I really don't know what to say about this matter. Let me pull up the questions. I'm gonna do my makeup and answer y'all's questions. What was my favorite thing about Cabo? And I'll definitely have to say my favorite thing about Cabo was the boat ride. We had so much fun in that boat ride. And I also loved the day at the beach. Am I going to Nigeria anytime soon? And yes, I plan to go to Nigeria this year, December 2022. Mark my words, I will be in Nigeria December 2022, honey. I'm not playing with y'all. Can you believe I have not been to Nigeria since I came to America? Partly because the funds just weren't there, but the funds are there now, and I will be in Nigeria this year. If I'm not with my family, I'm just gonna come anyway. I'ma see y'all there. Do I like a shaved head better than a head full of hair? It's not really that I like a shaved head better than a head full of hair, because of course if I had a healthy head of hair, I wouldn't have shaved my hair. Or maybe I still would have, I don't know. But something wanted, I just wanted to shave my head, y'all, and my hair wasn't healthy, and it was just like, you might as well shave your head and grow it all back. This is the perfect time to do that. I'm 22. I can grow another head of hair that is healthy. I shaved it twice because I wanted to kind of stimulate the hair growth, but it was just fun to play around with the bald look in the meantime. Why not? Like, who cares? I still look good and I was just having fun. Because y'all know I be putting on wigs anyway. I'll be quick to pop a wig on my head. So I really don't understand why y'all are so shocked. Someone also asked, do I prefer being bald? And has it boosted my confidence or dimmed it? It has definitely boosted my confidence. Oh, of course. Because the thing is, like, my head looks really, really good. I still look pretty. I'm still cute. Hair is not what makes me cute. Because y'all know, I'm always doing these hair videos. I always got a wig on. So it could be easy for me to feel like I'm only cute because I put these wigs on or whatever. Not saying that male validation is important to me, but I still be pulling. Okay? I have gotten some rude comments actually from like uncle type of people, but I don't really care. Like, please, it's nobody's business. How is school? School is cool. Stupid ass. School is school. Like, school is literally school. Who the freak cares? Like, literally every other day I'm talking about dropping out. School is just, it's cool. Like, I don't know what else to say about it. I'm still enrolled for the next semester. So someone said, why did I go bald and choose to stay bald? Just curious. I'm not choosing to stay bald. I'm just playing around with the bald look while I have it. I am gonna try to grow my hair back out. That's the whole point. I wanted my hair to be healthy again, and I needed to shave it off and start all over. Like, oh, I think that's it for all the questions about my head. Actually, I'm gonna answer one last one, and it's, did I lose engagement after my big chop? I think that's an interesting question to ask. The answer is, I don't know, because my engagement was flip-floppy before. It's flip-floppy now. Like, people pick and choose what they want to watch, and I don't think that anybody cares if I'm bald, because the type of content that I offer, people gain something for the most part, if you get what I'm saying, from watching my videos. I don't think I've lost engagement. I feel like my engagement is still the same. So yeah, that's the answer to that question. What are some things and habits that I need to leave or get rid of in 2022? Definitely underestimating myself, not putting in the work that I really know that I'm capable of putting in. Stop procrastinating. That's another thing that I do. I procrastinate and I get in my head about things. I get anxious about things and I end up not doing things because I'm anxious. I do a lot of self-sabotaging, and I'm really trying to stop that because it is not beneficial to my life, like, at all. How do you handle rejection or feelings that aren't reciprocated? This is a very good question, very interesting question from my good sis Momo the Bomb Diggity. This is a great question to ask me because I dealt with something recently that made me feel feelings of rejection. If I am flat out rejected, I'm like, okay, well, I guess it's time for me to move on. Honestly, because it's like, what else is left to say? There's nothing you can do about it. And it's gonna hurt for sure. But the truth is, you're gonna get over it. It's not the end of the world. Do whatever you have to do to help yourself get over those feelings. Y'all, I'm totally applying this wrong. It's supposed to be brush first and then beauty blender, but I did it wrong. Live your life, have your fun, get over it. That's what I try to do. Honestly, just do whatever you have to do for yourself, because that's all that matters is you. Poo. And then you go in with the beauty blender, do a little bit of that. How do I afford my lifestyle? Because girl, you're rocking. Through YouTube, sponsorships, videos, AdSense, all those things. And I don't really live a lavish lifestyle. I'm not really balling or anything. I don't know if that's what it seems like, but I'm not balling. I am very much doing well for myself. I've been making money on YouTube ever since I was monetized, basically. That has allowed me to make some money. And then when I started doing like hair videos and stuff, I started partnering with hair companies and they also pay me a certain fee. With growth for me comes money. So that is how I am able to afford my lifestyle. How did I become confident as a dark-skinned woman? This is a very good question that I've been asked a lot throughout my time I'm here on YouTube. I never really know how to answer the question, but to be honest, I feel like the way that I grow up plays a big part as to why I am so confident. I feel like I am confident in myself as a person overall, so that translates to me being confident of my skin color. I've never really felt like, oh my gosh, I have dark skin and that means I'm ugly. I've never really felt that way. I've never had anybody make me feel that way until I came to America. And I was already 9 years old when I came to America. You get a lot of your personality traits from the ages of when you're born till when you're 8. So by the time you're 8, you have developed habits and traits and beliefs, things like that. I didn't really have those beliefs. I never felt that feeling. And I know a lot of people who grew up in America, a lot of dark-skinned girls who grew up here in the United States, they go through that very early on. Like, yes, you are a dark-skinned black girl. They know. And I didn't know that until I came to the United States, because kids did used to call me very, very weird names that associated with me being dark-skinned. And for me, even when I was younger, I never believed anything those people said. It never really held much power to me. If anything, it made me fight them. What y'all got going on? Like, what are y'all doing? I've always had this confidence. And I had said this one time before, but I did low-key kind of grow up sheltered. I low-key did my makeup totally wrong from how I would usually do it. And so that's why it doesn't look as good as I wanted it to. Or maybe because I'm not done. I don't know. I never had to overcome anything. But my advice to any girls who do have to tell themselves they're beautiful and remind themselves they're beautiful, that's exactly what it is. Like, remind yourself that you're beautiful. Are you a good person? Are you a beautiful person? That is all that matters. Do not let society or whatever or people make you think that you are not beautiful because you are darker. Like, what? I'm using the Huda Beauty powder because this powder has been really, really good to me. Like, really good. Somebody asked, do I have a boyfriend? No, I don't have a boyfriend. I don't trust these niggas. That's on period. That's on period. I don't trust these niggas. And until I trust these niggas or trust a nigga, I will be single. Yeah, it is hard out here for a girl, okay? Finding a good man is not easy. And I definitely want to get married, okay? I want to have children. I want to have it all. But I am not going to rush anything. When am I going to sell more wigs? Y'all know that I sell wigs. Like, I literally have my own vendor. Ask me to buy a wig and I will get you a wig, babes. I will get you a wig exactly how you want it. I will even customize it for you exactly how you want it. All you have to do is show me a picture of exactly what you want and I'm going to do it. And it's that simple. It's that easy. But you got to ask. Ask and you shall receive. Okay? Because I get that a lot. Like, y'all always waiting for me to sell a wig, but the thing is, I don't be selling the wigs that I wear anymore because, you know, I be wearing them a lot and I don't think y'all want that. So you're just gonna have to buy one for me, hun. What's my religion? I am Christian and I am a child of God, okay? And as I'm her. Somebody asked if they can rub my head for good luck. only if you have good energy, because I don't want nobody with bad energy rubbing my head. I love shaved heads, and I was wondering if you're gonna dye it in the future. I'm not gonna dye it because I don't want my hair to be unhealthy. To dye your hair, you have to bleach it, and I don't want to do that. I'm ready for my hair to get back to a point that it's good, because like I said, I want to go to Nigeria in December, and when I go to Nigeria in December, I want to get some cute braids. I want to be able to live a carefree life with some braids, not a wig, honey, and just live my best life. So that's what we finna do. What do I use for dark spots on my chest and back area? I use the Good Molecules Discoloration Serum, and they actually have a 2.0 version now. I hope they send it to me because I'm supposed to be on their PR list, but that's what I use. I really want to try the 2.0. I tried to get it at Ulta, but they don't have it, so I think I might order it online. And I've also been using the Faded Moisturizer. This is pretty good too. If I was more consistent with it, I would see better results. But lately I've been consistent and my dark spots on my chest are clearing up pretty good. So I'm definitely gonna be more consistent with my remedies. But those are the only two that I know. Someone asked if I would consider getting the other side of my nose pierced. I actually would consider getting the other side of my nose pierced. And I have considered getting the other side of my nose pierced. I just haven't done it. I have a lot of piercings that I want. I just haven't gotten them, and I need to. What am I looking forward to the most in 2022? And I'm just looking forward to seeing my overall growth in general, where I get and what I do and all the fun things that I get into this year. Cause I'm here for a good time, okay? I'm here for a good time and a long, long time. And that's on purr. I like to chisel that cheek with this. Advice on how to stick down the size of your wig. Babes, I give all the best hair tips on my hair videos. I'm always learning new things and sharing new tips and tricks, so you guys should definitely be staying tuned to the hair videos. Honestly, just like how you watch makeup tutorials and stuff, the girls gotta get into the hair videos, because that's how you learn how to step up your wig game. Even some of y'all girls that be going to these hairstylists to get y'all hair done, but you don't even know how to keep up with your hair after you get it done, you need to learn these things. And I'm not even trying to shame you or anything. I'm just saying, like, it really does help. And I'd also say maybe use some glue, because I use glue all the time. I don't use hairspray or anything. I know a lot of people like to use hairspray, and I don't do that personally. Someone asked if I follow a particular workout. I do not have a workout. I do not work out. I just naturally have a slim body. Praise the Lord. Obashata. I got this mat on Amazon, which you can lay your hot tools on. It's perfectly safe. Alright guys, so my lashes are on, and I did get this package from Makeup Revolution. It's their new lash pal line. It comes with two different mascaras. There's the Lift and Define 5D Lash with Extreme Dimension. And then there's the 5D Lash Pal. My favorite thing about this lash applicator is the fact that you can just like pop it like this. It's closed, and then when you pop it like this, it opens the mascara, and then you just take out the wand. Very, very cute and efficient. I'm not gonna be using this one because this one does have a bigger applicator, and I'm only doing my bottom mascara. So today I am gonna be going for the Lift and Define, and this one has a more suitable applicator for the bottom lashes. So that's what I'm gonna use to define my bottom lashes. My enemy, if you know that. That is it for this video, guys. I absolutely love this look. Love the hair. The hair came out so good. I mean, just look at it. This dress color is giving the hair the pop that it deserves. Also, make sure to stay tuned for when I turn this hair pink, because that's definitely coming. And also follow me on my Instagram, which will be right here on the screen, because I do be popping on the gram, okay? And I'm also going to post pictures in this look, so definitely make sure to follow me on Instagram if you want to see the pics. And yeah, I know I didn't really answer questions that were like super interesting. I feel like the questions were kind of boring, honestly, but that's just my opinion. I hope you guys enjoyed it anyways. I am very excited for 2022, guys. I have so much in store this year, and I'm really just excited to bring everything into fruition and just do my best that I possibly can this year. I hope you guys are having a good year so far. I hope you guys are doing well in all your endeavors. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you watched for this long, I love you so much, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.